So the last time that we played, we got the Yugi starter deck, and I don't think we edited the deck after we got it. We also couldn't even beat the dog last time we played, so hopefully with Yugi's deck we'll be able to make some good additions. I gotta hope that Ryokushin is not gonna be needed anymore. White Magical Hat will probably use at some point, but right now he is too weak to, like, every time I draw it, it's just completely dead. These 1200 guys are totally useless. I really don't want to play Yukaza either, but I feel like I don't have much of an option at this point. I'll see. I don't know how many cards of the water deck or from the Yugi deck will be able to add in. Hopefully a good amount. Well, let's look at all before we're taking stuff out. Time Wizard, definitely worth adding. Thanks for the host. Cool format, tell you. Tributes, we want to stay away from. Sangin, definitely going in. Armored Lizard, bigger than our other monsters. Oh, we must have got the Joey starter, not the Yugi one. Hey, Monk. Thanks for checking out the stream. Dragon Statue, no. Flame of the Player, no. Princess Tatsuri. Put it in as a maybe. Sword of Destruction. Can we use this at all? 400 for a dark monster. I don't know. What does dark energy do? 300 for a fiend. That's less likely to be useful. That's for insects, for dragons. Malevolent Nuzzler, definitely worth using. $1,400 is higher than some other stuff. Magician of Fate, awesome. Seven colored fish for sure. Guardian of the Sea. Mahavilo. Good. Penguin Soldier, yes. Panther Warrior we could probably make work. I'm sure I could at least just leave it in attack mode. Remove Trap I said no to before, but they have way more trap cards early in this game than I thought they would. I might even go with the two remove traps. Like, they keep using Trap Hole on me. I wish I remembered if the blinking red meant the card is banned or not. I guess I'll put it in for now and find out. Seven tools, yes. Block attack. Yep, that's useful. That might be useful. Neo 17 is good, Wabaku is good. Maybe. Karate Man we could use. Alright, yeah, there's a lot more beaters in here now. So I don't think maybe blinking means it's limited. Blinking red is banned, blinking blue is limit. Okay, what was change of heart? Well, I'll go through the whole deck again. Yeah, getting the second starter was definitely the move. I think we can dump now. Hit to Sumi Giant. Should be weak enough. Thirteen hundreds can go. I don't think this is going to do that much damage right now. So Dark Hole's blinking blue, so I think you're definitely right in being limited. Water Girl's out. Garden Sea's out. Sorry, I'm down to 36 cards though. I'm gonna have to add some of this stuff back. Yeah, I think you're right. So Change of Heart ain't gonna work either. Alright, so we need six more cards. No, four more cards. That's not too brutal. I guess I'll keep Blue Eyes in for now, because it seems like there's some stuff that just can't get over it. What are our other options? Oh, Spirit of the Heart, for sure. We need three more cards. This thing seems somewhat usable. This one could at least go on Mahavala. Oh wow, I'm a fool. So the deck number, we're at 59 cards. Okay, I can drop a ton of stuff. I was looking at the level 1 to 4 stars. The UI in this game is just hideous. Alright. I can jump so many things then. Thank you. Okay. Awesome. I'm still not totally sure how to see the ban list. Can't even move our computer chair. I think we're ready to beat Taya. I want revenge on the dog from last time. Maybe we're not ready to beat Taya. Guardian Saint Joan and Cure Mermaid. So we're not beating Guardian Saint Joan anytime soon. I still only have like 3 pieces of monster removal. Of course, didn't even attack with a nimble first. Taya's too good for that. Well, here we go. Let's go heads. Woo! Hopefully that will swing this battle. Just make sure this doesn't do anything that I don't know. It's on top of your deck, okay. One of your monsters destroyed by battle this turn to your hand. Okay. Thank you. that time wizard was clutch. Okay. Even though Taya is still over 8,000 life points. Drains my life points, but it shouldn't be enough to beat me before I can tribute it off. Panther Warrior, start getting some damage on the board. A much harder game than I thought it was going to be against Taya, but I've said that almost every match I've played now, so... I don't even trust her to not have Karibo. Win with the new deck, thanks to Time Wizard's Time Magic. She said, I think I'm quitting. Wow. That's okay, Tay. That's what I thought every time I've dueled someone this game so far. More light collection packs. Let's open these bad boys up. All junk. So that's where BLS is, hiding in there somewhere. Let's duel this nerd. Wow, this actually looks like a real hand. The good BLS is in that pack, yeah. If BLS wasn't in this game, I wouldn't even play it. I'm just trying to make the closest as I can to the GOAT format deck. I heard there's a Toon Blackbuster Soldier coming out. That probably looks pretty cool. Wicked Worm Beast, the first spirit monster. Torrential, we gotta get Torrential. I think from here on out I'm gonna save the points and try to just buy the cards one at a time. I think for 1,000 I could get one copy of everything. The full Toon Modern deck would be good enough in GOAT meta. I don't know what all the new Toons do. I assume they all have crazy effects and they probably would be good. Any modern card I've read has like a million effects on it. Like every card that comes out in Yu-Gi-Oh! Now has an effect like longer than Thousand Eyes Restrict. Who Thousand Eyes Restrict, they didn't even fit all of its effect on the card the first time they printed the thing. Lost our dark hole. Let's try this person. So yeah, I'm gonna try to get to 1,000 DP points or whatever they stand for, duels points, I guess. And then I'm going to just try to like get BLS with that and see if that works. That's what I read. For 1,000 points a day, you could get like a any single card or something. This is more what I was expecting off the bat. I guess you need the second deck to be able to get to this point. So far so good. This guy doesn't seem to have too many big monsters. Thank you. So, do you think this game... When I was Googling for this game, Shadow, it said that the game before this was better. Is the... Like, just in generally, like, features and stuff. So you think the 2004 game was made better than this one? Really? That's crazy. What are, like, the big differences? I mean, stupid stuff like I can't use this set remove trap. I'm pretty sure I've used spells that I set before too, so I don't know why I can't use this one. That much difference, huh? Even the music is better? Jeez. Yeah, this so far I've only heard one song. I'm very tempted to switch to that Nightmare Troubadour game. I think I wanted like... I don't know. I don't know how many hours is worth putting into this game before switching. The GBA soundboard is so sad. I think the saddest thing of GBA soundboard is they redid Donkey Kong Country 3 with the composer that did the Donkey Kong Country 1 and 2 did for 3, but only for the Game Boy Advance. Like on the SNES, the Donkey Kong Country 3 soundtrack is garbage. But then he like wrote the soundtrack for the third game, but it's like, it just feels so weak on the GBA. Yeah, David Wise. It's like a crime that he like wrote it for the GBA instead of the SNES. It would be awesome if someone like tried to transfer those songs over to like use like the same like beats and stuff, but make it better. Golden Sun, yeah. I'm playing the Mega Man Zero games right now, but I don't know how much they changed or not. It's the Mega Man Zero games for the Switch. I'm playing that right now, and it sounds good on there. I don't know how much they changed it or not. I've actually never played Golden Sun. Didn't Golden Sun, like, actually... Yeah, so I've enjoyed the music and that so far. I'll admit I'm being a scrub and playing it on, like, with the extra save points, though. Or I didn't think I'd ever be able to play that game. It's too next level for me. Does Golden Sun, is that the game where it like makes a difference if you play it at nighttime or daytime? Sorry guys that I was like completely silent for half that those last two games. I was on the phone. No, Golden Sun's not nighttime or dark time. I don't know what game I'm confusing that with then. I know it came out around the same time. I guess that was the cat slash dog that I just beat. I want my revenge on the regular dog. Let me see how many points I have. Thank you. Play 4,500 or 1,282 duelist points. I don't want anything. Alright, what I want to do right now is put in a passcode. How do I do it? Either way, I'm gonna save. Guess I'm gonna try to Google how to put in the passcode. To go grab my actual card so I can put the code in from it too. Alright, so what I read online is that with 1,000 duelist points, I could put in the code for a card. And then retrieve at least one copy of that card. So, we're gonna start the powerhouse. We'll try to get BLSs. Yeah, I'll check the video out. I believe you, 2004 is better. That was like every review that I saw of this game said it was like, how do you go backwards? Do you have a Switch, Shadow? Yeah, there's definitely enough, like, cool, like, retro-style games. Oh yeah, yeah, definitely gotta put live stuff ahead of gaming. But there's definitely a bunch of cool, like, new version of retro game stuff that, like, it's totally worth getting for that reason. I've really enjoyed it. Oof, yep. Cars will do it. Alright, let's see. I didn't type in the date of the game. codes. I just want to know where to do it. Yeah, coronavirus is starting to get crazy over here too. I work at the health department, so I spent the last 2 days going to like every grocery store, giving them information about coronavirus. And then Connecticut's under a state of emergency now too, so like our phones are getting blown up at the health department. Yeah, like every like big chain box store that I've gone to inspect has been insane. Like Sam's Club, BJ's and stuff like that. People are going nuts in there. So where the heck is this password machine? That's awesome you got your degree though, congrats. Not that I have any idea where we got it, but I know we both went through the struggle of finishing school. So this is just telling me press R at the password machine. Is this thing the password machine? Okay, sweet. See if I could read this with my old man eyes without the without my kit and my glasses. 7 2 9 8 9 4. I feel like we're 3/4 away there getting BLS. Where is that deck editor? BLS not right at the top. Alright. Do you not get the card by putting it in the password machine? Where the hell is he? Oh my god, is he banned? I don't remember if red... What did he tell me before? Blinking red is banned. Fuck! Why? Why would he be banned in a 2005 game? All right, this is officially the last episode and the end of Yu-Gi-Oh! World Championship 2005 for this stream. The banning of Blackluster Soldier is enough for me. I think this game does have multiple ban lists. I don't care to play it enough to find out. And next time we'll check out Yu-Gi-Oh! Trovador for the DS or something, because I am too upset that Blackluster Soldier is banned. So I will catch you guys later. I think I'm gonna stream some Duel Book tonight, but that is the end. This is gonna be part 2 of 2 of Yu-Gi-Oh! 7 Trials of Glory.